this is Stampy, and welcome to a Minecraft Let's Play video. Today I am doing another challenge against Ballistic Squid, who is that man over there. Today we are doing the 24-hour challenge, and this is quite a unique challenge, and essentially what I'm really looking forward to. So what the idea is that we have 24 hours, and I mean 24 Minecraft hours, not real hours, don't worry, to gather as many different items as we can. So I need to run around to get some dirt, get grass, get torches, get whatever I can. Then I come into my little house here, and I arrange them all on these item frames. After the 24 hours, I then need to look into Squid Nugget's house, where he would have done the same, and all of the items he's got, I need to try and get again, and you get a point for every item that the other person wasn't able to get. So basically, the aim of the game is I need to try and find as many difficult items that it's going to be hard for a Squid Nugget to be able to find. So if I get diamonds or, like, I don't know, just rare items, then that means there's a better chance. Or I could just try and get as many different items as I can, so then that way it's going to be difficult for him to get them. And the way we're going to mark when the day, or the 24 hour begins and ends, is by this beacon. So in the morning, this beacon's going to light up, which means we have begun, and then it's going to go off again, and then when it goes back on, it means that we have to switch around, and then it's going to go off again, then when it goes back on, it means time is up. So we've been a little bit nice. We've given us a few items here. We've got our basic tools, we've got some torches, we've of course got our map, which we started with, some pumpkin pies, as well as a golden apple. We're not allowed to use these items, though. I couldn't just go and put this golden apple straight in the item frame. That would be that wouldn't be fair. So let's just go and get everything organized in my inventory, and let's begin. Actually, let's take a little cheeky look at the map and see. So there's a desert up there, and I know there's a jungle nearby. I could get some rare things, but I don't really have a game plan. But Squid Nugget looks ready, so I guess we can begin. I'm also going to be doing a timer just on my screen as well, just for me, so I can have a bit of an idea. You know, I don't want to be down in the mine just as the 24 in-game hours is up, because otherwise, yeah, I wouldn't be able to get the items on. The rule is that as soon as that beacon comes on and the 24 hours is over, then that means you're out of time. So I think the first thing I want to do is I'm going to make sure Squid Nugget doesn't see. Yep, he's ran away. I'm going to go and I'm going to try and start a wheat farm. I think might be a good idea. If I start growing wheat, like, straight away, then that way I'd be able to do a little wheat farm. Actually, there's some coal up here as well. I might as well grab some coal while I'm here. And I want to go to a mine. Where did that coal go? I'm sure I saw. Oh, it's up there. Right, actually, what I want to do is I need to make a hoe. I didn't actually give us a hoe. So let me go and cut down a tree. Oh, there's a chicken here as well. Is it going to lay an egg? If this chicken laid an egg, that would be very handy, because eggs are quite difficult to find. So let's just go and make it so I can make myself a hoe. And then I'm going to go and start doing some planting immediately, and just try and grow myself a little bit of wheat. Because with wheat, I could make, like, I can make all sorts of stuff. I can make cookies and bread, and if he's not growing any wheat, it's going to be very difficult for him to be able to get any of those items. So once I've got a little bit of wheat growing, then I'm going to go and try and head straight down to a mine. So let's see if I can get any more seeds. There we go. There's another bit of seeds there. There's not much grass around here, to be fair. I guess I just break as much as I can as I wander around the area. Any eggs? Well, actually, if I did get an egg as well, I'd have a good chance of being able to make a pumpkin pie. And oh, was that some rotten flesh? I might as well grab that just in case he doesn't meet any googlies. And actually, that was this is quite a big deep tunnel. Oh, look at that. Look how deep that goes. That might be a good place to go mining, to try and get deep. Like, imagine if I got a diamond. If I got a diamond, then that would be amazing. Like, that would be almost a guaranteed item that he would not be able to find. So let's go and see if I can get any more seeds. Nope. I really want to start planting some more, actually. And then if I get some bone meal, then I can grow it. So I know I'm wasting a lot of time on one item, but I think it's pretty much guaranteed an item that Squid Nugget would not be able to get. So let's just try and get a little bit more, so I could make some a few different things out of it. I think making a cake would probably be out of the question, unfortunately. Are you going to give me one more little bit of seeds? If not, I think this will be okay. Right, I think I'm wasting too much time, so I'm just going to go and do it. Let's try and make a little secret wheat farm down here. So let's go and make myself a crafting table as fast as we can. And we are allowed to use crafted items, so I could put the crafting table in the item frame as well. It doesn't have to be, you know, just coal and just items that you would just find by themselves. You can make new items. So let's go and plant all my stuff down here, make my little hidden wheat farm, and then I'm going to go and head straight down into the cave. So I think I got 6 wheat seeds in the end, which isn't too bad. So hopefully this would have just grown in time. And if not, I can go and try and hunt down some bone meal. So there we go. That's all there, nicely growing away. That did waste quite a lot of time, but I think it's okay. I think if I go down to a mine now and get everything I need, I should be okay. And there's quite a lot of gravel as well. It'd be good to get some... I can make flint and steel and stuff. And oh look, there's a swamp over there. Actually, before I go to the mine, because otherwise I'm going to forget, I might head to the swamp and see if I can get a mushroom. And if I can get both types of mushrooms, I could make mushroom stew, and that could be a pretty handy thing. Actually, and if I made shears as well, then I could get the vines, and I could get some of the leaves as well. And there's also sugarcane over there, and the good chance is that Squid's going to find sugarcane anyway, but it would be worth grabbing some. And just anything on the way that I haven't got yet, I might as well grab, like sand. I might as well just grab a little bit of sand, just so, you know, just so I have it. You know, like, it's quite an easy thing to make, but it's just something else that Squid's going to have to do. Actually, if I get a bit more sand, then that way I can make some sand stone as well, could be quite handy. So let's go and break up a little bit of this sand, just so I can make some sandstone, maybe some chiseled sandstone and things like that. And I can now go and grab this sugarcane, and there we go, there are some mushrooms right ahead of me, and hopefully Squid's not going to find this swamp, so that way I'll be able to grab quite a lot of them. Oh, what about a lily pad as well? Did I get it? Yeah, I got a lily pad as well. If he doesn't come to the swamp, that's going to be a hard thing for him to find. So there we go. I got a couple mushrooms. I'll take a few just in case I do find a red mushroom. Then I can make some mushroom stew. And right, I'm going to go back to where I found that big hole. And yeah, hopefully go down deep down and be able to get some things. So I think gold would be a good thing to find. I also think, redstone would be quite good. I mean, diamonds and emeralds would obviously be the ideal, because they'd be very rare, but yeah, I'm not gonna spend my whole time in the mine. I think in the morning I can come up to the top, and then that's when I can go and try and take out some skeletons to get some bone meal, you know, and also getting things like spider eyes and things would be pretty handy. But yeah, so getting iron, coal, redstone, and gold, I think will be my main goals for going down here. So let's do it. Luckily I got a sword already, which should help me out. Let's go and try and find where that big hole was. I think it was right about here somewhere. Oh, let's have a quick check on the egg count. There we go. Look, there's an egg. Look, if I grab this egg and then, sorry chicken, take out the chickens, not only do I get the feathers as well, it means it's going to stop him from being able to get the egg. And actually, did I get 2 eggs then? Oh, this is good, which means that if I do find a pumpkin now, I got everything I need to make a pumpkin pie, which will be very difficult for him to make. But first, let's go down into this big hole. Let's get my hunger up. I do have my golden apple in case things get a little bit dangerous. I want to be very careful making my way down here if I can. And I should probably grab a little bit of this coal, actually, before I head down. Actually, no, I've got torches on me already anyway, don't I? Right, forget that. I do not need that coal. I can grab some more later on just to put it in the item frame, but that doesn't matter too much. And whoa, this cave is amazing. Oh, look how deep down I'm going. Right, there's got to be a bunch of good loot down here. Yep, it keeps going down. Oh, look, is that gold? I think I can see gold already. If that is, that would be absolutely amazing. I do need to get some iron first, though, I think, just to make myself an iron pickaxe, just so I can gather up the gold. This is great, though, because it's also going to be very easy for me to get back up to the surface. We do have keep inventory on, which means that if I do need to get up to the surface quickly, then I can just basically jump in lava or something, and then I'm going to respawn back at home if I need to. But yeah, I don't want to be heading up yet. So I got this gold. I want to avoid the lava. Actually, I could bucket up some lava. Now! Creeper! Creeper! That was a creeper. Where did he come from? Right, let's go and try and make my way up here. Oh, look! Emeralds! Did you see that? There's emeralds right here. This is amazing. Right, let's try and get over this lava if we can. Up, 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 up. Jump over. Let's get rid of this lava for now. There's more lava that I can gather if I need it. And let's just get some iron then first, and then I can go and start mining these things. I can't believe I got emeralds. That is amazing. Emeralds are so rare. It is very dark behind here, though. There's another zombie coming after me. And look, oh no, and a skeleton. Right, skeletons are good because I did want to take one out. out to get the bow mill, but they're also very dangerous. Let's go and get my golden apple at hand, just so I have it ready. The zombie shouldn't be much of a problem. Here's the skeleton, though. Let's go and try and take him out. I've only got a stone sword, but there we go. No problem. Did it drop any bones, though? Nope. No bones were dropped. Oh, look, there's more emeralds. I don't need more emeralds, though. It only matters about getting one of each item, so more emeralds doesn't matter, but I might as well mine it anyway, just to stop Squid from finding it. And let's go and get this this iron then, shall we? Seems to be right down here. Oh look, there's a is that an abandoned mine shaft down here? Oh, there's got to be a bunch of cool things in here. Right, I don't want to spend my whole time in this cave because there's a whole bunch of things on the surface I want to find as well. But let's go and start smelting this just so I can make a pickaxe then, shall we? So let's go and I need to get some more cobblestone to make a furnace. I think I'm just under halfway through my time. So I'm definitely going for the tactic of getting the rare items. I don't know if Squid's doing the same or he might be just be trying to get a load of common items. I think both strategies are good ideas, but yeah, I have no idea what he's doing. So let's go and start this smelting. I think there's a little bit more up here, so that way I can try and make some flint and steel or anything else. And look, there's some redstone down there as well. This has been an amazing trip, because if I could maybe get some like melon seeds or something from the abandoned mineshaft, which would be near on impossible for Squid to find unless he came down here as well. So let's go and put the rest of this in, and then once that iron's finished, I can go and make myself an iron pickaxe, and then I can go and start gathering up some things up. And look, the other type of mushroom! The other type of mushroom I need. Oh, this has been an amazing trip. And oh, here's a creeper. I could actually maybe get some gunpowder here if I'm careful and keep knocking it back. Oh, there's a zombie there as well I want to be careful about. But getting some gunpowder would be pretty handy. How many more hits to take it out? There we go, it's gone. Nope. Sadly, no gunpowder for me, though. Let's go take out this zombie. I can grab these mushrooms, and I think there's a little bit more iron here as well, which I could grab, maybe make some iron armor. It could be quite good, and an iron sword as well would definitely help protect me. So I might as well leave all of this smelting. Let's try and gather this up as quick as we can. I know I'm wasting time here, but I think it's worth it. I think I'm doing the long-term plan. I'm investing my time now to hopefully give me a good advantage later on. So let's go and eat some more pie. Ah, there's a bat! That actually scared me then. Right, let's go over this way, and let's go and put this all into the furnace then. Let's go and throw it all in, and I can gather everything else that was in there. Right, so let's go and make myself a sword first, and well, a pickaxe first, and then a sword as well. I need to make a stick first, of course. You can't make a sword without a stick. And there we go. Right, let's go now and try and start gathering up some things, though. Let's upgrade my weaponry, and let's start mining then, shall we? So we have we've got some gold here. I can go and grab some of this, because this is going to be very handy. I might as well grab a little bit just in case I can make something else out of the gold. Like, I could make like detector rails, like power rails and things as well, which he shouldn't be able to make unless he's gone and got redstone and things as well. So let's go and grab as much of this as we can, and then let's go. I want to look. There's that chest right up there. I want to just go and have a look in it and just see if there's anything cool in there. If not, I'm not going to go any further that way, because I do want to spend some time on the surface. I definitely want to go back to my wheat and see if I can find a pumpkin as well. Would be very handy, and also making a cookie. Right, let's go here. Oh, got some gold there, and some gold, and a saddle. There we go. I could also steal the minecart, because why not? There we go. It means he's going to have to make a minecart, and I can't see any chest nearby either, so I'm not going to worry about exploring there too much. I'm going to get stuck in a cobweb instead and then fall down. Am I down? There we go. I'm down. All right, let's go and gather up the emeralds and the redstone and some of the other things. The only thing we haven't really found is a diamond, but I knew that was a very rare possibility anyway, so I'm not too worried about that. That was kind of to be expected. Right, then let's be careful of the lava down there. Actually, if I go and I could go and bucket some up now, actually. If I go and make myself a bucket, I can go and grab some and put it in here. Let's go and try and be very careful and go and grab some of this lava here. And there we go. That's going to be quite a difficult thing for Squid to get. I need to be careful here, because I'm going to run out of room in my in my inventory. I'm doing so well, I'm kind of running out of room to carry all of these things. So, oh look, there's some more emeralds up there. I'm finding emeralds all over the place, actually, to be honest. And let's go and I can put some. I got some dirt, actually. I'll use that to cover this lava so I can get to everything that I need. And then I'm going to go and start thinking about heading out of this cave and going back to the surface to try and gather everything else I need. So the redstone was here. Let's go and get my pickaxe, and I can go and mine this redstone. And that's pretty much all I need for redstone. Gonna have a quick check around the corner just to make sure there's not diamonds right here that I would have missed otherwise. There doesn't seem to be, so I'm not gonna worry about hunting for diamonds too much. I don't want to go too deep into the cave either, because then I got a chance of not finding my way back. And already I've just got confused. I already turned the corner and I'm already getting confused. Here we go. This is where I came from. All right, let's go and try and grab these emeralds. Hopefully they're not gonna burn in the lava. Yep, there we go. I got myself an emerald. And I'm running out of room here. Let's go and throw away the chest, because I don't really need that, and I don't really need the sticks either. And let's go and throw away those items. And now let's go and head back up to the surface then, shall we? Luckily it should be relatively easy to get back up there. I didn't go down too deep. I might as well grab the rest of this iron just so I have that. And let's go and make my way out of here then, shall we? I'm gonna go and head back up this way. Oh, I should have grabbed some of those mine carts actually. And some of the tracks would have been quite handy, but I guess I don't want to worry about it too much. I might as well go grab these emeralds just in case Squid does come down this same cave. I don't want him to be able to get them easily either. And let's go back to the surface then. We are starting to run out of time. So I think I'm definitely going for difficult items. So remember, I can do what Squid did. I can just go and get back to the surface by killing myself, can't I? That is a smart idea. Thanks for reminding me, Squid. I don't know whether he did that intentionally or not, but yeah, it's not a bad idea either way. So if I just go in this lava, I'm gonna respawn at the house and have everything that I should have had. So what I might as well do now is start filling up this wall with some of these items, because my pockets are getting rather full. So let's go and put the lava in. I'm gonna do that very carefully. I might as well go and put a rose in there as well. I can put one of my eggs in there, just like this. And I can go and put the feather as well. Might be quite a difficult thing for him to find. So I can go and put my feather in here like this. I'm doing quite well. This is quite a nice selection of random things as well, isn't it? I can go and put some of my sugar cane in there if I can. I'm getting all jumbled up here. There we go. I can put the saddle in. It's something that I can put in quite easily. I can also put the mine cart in. And what's this here? Did I get a... Oh, that's the emeralds. They look really weird in this texture pack. I'm going to put one of the emeralds in there. He's going to be very annoyed when he sees that. And I can also put the... Actually, if I put... I could put the gold and the gold ore in. So then that way it's two different items, you know, but if he hasn't got gold, then he's not going to be able to get either of them. That's quite a cheeky tactic that will work. Also, the redstone is going to be a good thing to put in. And then I'm going to go and store a bunch of these other things just in the chest for now. Just to keep it safe, and then that way I can have some more room in my inventory as well as I go hunting for other items. So let's go now and have a little bit of a wander and see what else we can find. I'm just going to put the gold in to make sure I can't forget, and I want to be very careful looking into the sky now just to make sure that that I'm careful that to not run out of time. So let's go and have a little bit of a look and see how my wheat's doing, if it's grown at all. And hopefully I can find some skeletons to get some bone meal in case it hasn't grown. Has it grown? And no, it hasn't grown corn completely yet. So let's go now and try and find some skeletons. I'm also going to go to the jungle and see if I can find any cocoa beans. So then that way, as well as bread, I'll also be able to make some cookies. I want to make cookies as well. So yeah, that would be handy. And also keeping an eye out for pumpkins would be a very nice thing to find as well. And there we go, I can see some cocoa beans on the horizon already. Oh look, there's a skeleton over here. It's very dark right now. I want to keep putting these torches down. Let's get as close to the skeleton as I can quickly so I don't get stuck. I want to take this out as fast as we can, and hopefully it's going to drop a bone. Please drop a bone. There we go, it dropped a bone for me. That's good. So I'm going to get the cocoa bean, then I think I'm just going to head back. I think that I want to make sure that I'm very safe. As I mentioned, as soon as the beacon turns on, that means time is up. And so anything Yeah, anything that hasn't been put in will not count. So I want to be very careful. And as you can see, the moon is already starting to go down. So I'm a little bit panicky right now. I got to be very quickly crafting all of my items. And I saw a cocoa bean a second ago, and now I can't see it right. It's just about up there. If I climb up these vines, I should be just about be able to break it from here. Can I? Can I break it from down here? Nope, I need to climb up. Come on, Stampy, you're wasting time. You're wasting time. Break the cocoa beans. And did I get them? Did I get them? I got them. Right. So I can now hopefully go and make a cookie, which will be probably something that he would not be able to make. So let's go now and head back to the house. And now I'm going to spend the rest of my time just making the items and putting them away rather than trying to gather new items. But what am I doing? I got to get over this hill. Come on, just dig over the hill. This is Minecraft. There doesn't need to be a staircase there already. So remember, the way that the time is going to be marked as time up is when the beacon goes on. So it doesn't go on immediately. No, there's some snow over there. Oh, it'd be good to get the snow. If I do have spare time at the end, I could go and maybe try and gather some snow to put down. Could be quite a difficult thing. I think my big way of winning, though, is going to be the wheat as well as the emeralds and things, because I don't think he went to a mine. I don't know, but I didn't really see him going down into a cave. So if he didn't, I think that's going to be where my big advantage is going to lie. Right, so let's go down here. Let's go and make my bone into bone meal like this, and let's go and grow all of my wheat here. This is actually the perfect amount of bone meal to grow at all. Actually, no, it doesn't all grow completely, does it? Has that grown? Oh, no, I didn't. I just wasted some. There we go. There's wheat. And if I grow that one as well, there's some more wheat. Oh, no, that one didn't grow enough. Okay, there we go. I've got enough wheat to do at least something with it. I think I should be able to make a cookie at least. So let's now go back to the house, and let's just go and craft everything, because, yeah, as you can see, the moon is getting very low. And as soon as that beacon goes on, time is going to be up. So excuse me, zombie, I do not want to fight you. Let's just go inside and do whatever we can. So I'm going to go and... Alright, let's go and make a cookie and put that on. That's going to be a difficult thing for him to make, and I can eat the rest of the cookies. I can cook this chicken, because if he hasn't got chicken at all, then that is going to be good. And actually, I can make a bunch of gold armor, because that way he's going to have to go and get some gold. So let's see if I can make some more gold armor. Let's go make a gold chest plate as well. He's going to have to go and try and contend with trying to do that. What else could I put on that I haven't put down? Have I put down that other mushroom yet? I could just go and put down some things. That's going to be just annoying for him to go and gather. The beacon is still not on yet, so I still have a little bit more time. What else have I? I could put some cocoa beans down. I've not put those down yet. Is there anything else that I could craft? I guess I could craft something with the iron, maybe. I could go and make an iron bucket. I could make a bowl. I could put a bowl down. I'm just going to go crazy here and put down as many different items as we can. The beacon's up. The beacon's up. I can't. The time is up, which means this is the end of episode number one. And episode number two, I'm going to go into Squid's house and try and see what he's done and make everything that he has made. But that's the end of this episode now. I want to thank you all very much for watching, and I will see you all later. Bye!